Yeah, starts 1:30 and officially ends at 2:45. But it's been long days, you know, several days in the past for our brothers. So if you have questions or, you know, response to the message, you know, we can share too. So he yeah. said he doesn't have voice now. So whatever question that we ask, he asked Brother Gao to answer that first.
You don't understand. I won't translate.
Okay, so shall we begin with a short prayer? Lord, thank you again. We know that your presence is with us. How much do you desire to be with your children? And through your word, you encourage your children on this journey toward the heavenly Jerusalem.
Yes,
we are called the heavenly brother.
Yes.
A holy brother, partaker of a heavenly calling.
Yes.
May our eyes focus on the end goal that we're going to reach to the new Jerusalem together.
Yes. Amen.
We just commit this time into your hand. As you do, bless our fellowship in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, 弟兄姐妹有问题，或者说 okay, if you have a response, you know, to our brother's message, you know, just go ahead and share. Okay, and if we finish early, we finish early, so we don't have to to get all the way to 2:45.
Are we finished yet?
Yeah. Okay.
I know. 我知道我们互相里的妹妹三九。
I know, just as your sister didn't have to move to the physical Jerusalem. We are here already in Jerusalem.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
I can go home now.
My question is, when we are living in Jerusalem, we need to pay a price.
他有这个经历，就是说，如果寻求神，按我们愿意付代价。How
to ask the Lord to make me willing?
Yeah.
我想请弟兄跟我们分享一下，神是怎么带领你愿意付代价的？Want
you to share how you become willing? When you became willing, what price you have paid? Your own experience in this becoming willing.
All right, I'll try to answer some of your questions.
我试着回答一下你的问题，一些问题。
I remember a book, a Watchman Nee book. I think it's called, it's been years, The Breaking of the Spirit. What is it called?
Release
of the Spirit.
Yeah.
我记得尼弟兄有一本书叫做《人的破碎和灵的出来》。
When I got to the section in there, and it was talking about paying the cost.
在那本书里面有一段讲到付代价。The
Lord's word was very convicting.
主的话非常的让我得到开启。I
knew what I was called to do.
我知道神呼召我做什么。But
I didn't have the strength to obey.
但是我却没有力量来顺服。So
I thought, you know, here I am a Christian, but this is too painful for me to choose.
所以我觉得我是个基督徒，但是呢，这件事情却很痛苦，让我来顺服。
So I won't tell you the specific thing.
我不会告诉你具体是什么事。
I'd rather just apply the principle.
我就是要来应用一下这个原则。
So that's when I stayed under the conviction. It never left me.
所以我一直在有，我一直有那样的一个确信，一个确信在我的心里边，这件事情是真的。
When I would pray, I would think about it.
所以每次我祷告的时候，我都想到这件事情。And
it became unbearable.
然后到了一定程度就难以忍受。I
thought the Lord has saved me, and I've been walking with Him, and now He asked me to do this.
所以我已经信了主，而且与主同行，但是现在主好像要求我要做这件事。So
that's the time I went to Brother Kong.
这个就是我最后不得不去找江弟兄。And
like I said this morning, so this may be a short answer. Like I said this morning. I expected, because I was under such conviction of the Holy Spirit.
因为我那个时候觉得非常清楚，这是圣灵叫我做的。
Now, by the way, this wasn't a sinful thing I was dealing with.
顺便说一下，这个并不是说什么犯罪的事情需要对付。
This was a very legitimate thing.
而是一个非常的，就是说合理的一件生活中的事情。
But this is something the Lord asked me to give up.
但是呢，是神要我放弃的一件事。
And I couldn't give it up.
但是我没有办法放弃。
It wasn't that I was hiding in sin anything.
不是好像我因为犯罪我要躲避神这样子的事情。
And sometimes the Lord will bring you to new places in your life and he'll say, are you willing?
有些时候神会带我们到了一个地步，他就好像在那边向我们挑战说，你是不是愿意放弃。
And many times it's a test.
很多时候是一个试验，是一个考验。
You remember Genesis 22, Abraham?
Mm-hmm.
Isaac.
创世纪二十二章亚伯拉罕献以撒的事。
How does it begin? And God tested Abraham.
那边说到神要试验亚伯拉罕。
Can you imagine when the Lord said to Abraham, "Take now thy son"?
你可以想象一下，神在那个时候对他说，你要把你的儿子带来。
Thine only son.
你唯一的儿子，你独生的儿子。
The one thou lovest,
而且是你所爱的。
The Lord was driving the stake deeper, I think.
神一步一步地让他意识到这件事情的重要性。
And offer him as a sacrifice on the mountain, I'll show you.
要在我所指示你的山上把它献为燔祭。
This was the promised heir.
这位是那个蒙应许的那个后裔。
This was the miracle of God.
他而且也是神的神迹。
This wasn't about sin.
这个不是关于犯罪的事。
It wasn't that he failed.
不是，也不是因为他犯罪，失败。
But this was a test.
然而，这是神那边来的一个试验。
Is the Lord enough?
神足够了吗
？For me, I questioned it.
但是对我来讲，我还是有疑问。
So when I went to Brother Kong,
所以我去找江弟兄。
As I mentioned already,
我已经提过这件事情。
He is such a gentle brother.
他是这样子的一位温柔的弟兄。
I appreciate brothers like that.
我非常的感谢有这样的弟兄。
Because here it was a young man, and I forget how old I was. I was in my 20s.
我那个时候还是二十多岁，一个年轻人。
And this could have been the moment I walked away from the Lord.
我甚至可以说，在那个时候我就有可能会离开主。
But those precious and gentle words I've never forgotten.
然而这样子的一些非常宝贵的，而且是带着恩典温柔的话语，我永远不会忘记。
They were some of the kindest words ever said to me.
是对我一生中间听到过的最让我感觉慈爱的话。
Think about it. He didn't say you just need to be willing.
你可以想象一下，他并没有对我说你就是应该顺服，你应该愿意放弃。
That would have been fair.
这个其实要这样说也没有错。
He could have said, "What do you mean you won't give up this to follow the Lord? Do you know how?" Much importance it is to follow the Lord.
他甚至可以说，你到底什么意思？你不能放弃这些事情来跟随主？你不想跟随主吗
？But he said the kindest thing to me.
他是用了这样子的一个慈爱的话来对我说。
He said, "Just ask the Lord something."
就是去问问主，
ask
去求主。
Tell the Lord.
告诉主。
I'm willing to be willing.
我愿意使你让我愿意让你使我成为愿意。
That broke through my resistance.
这个就实际上把我的那个抵抗的心拿走。
I was a free man when he said those words.
当他这样对我说的时候，那个时候其实我是有选择的自由的。
I knew it was impossible for me.
我知道对我来讲我是不可能放弃。
But it wasn't impossible for him.
然而对他来讲并不是不可能的。
I knew at that moment he had brought me to a place in the Christian life to see that the Christian life doesn't depend on me.
所以在那个点，神已经把我带到一个地步，让我看到基督徒的生命或者生活并不取决于我。
And so I began to pray that prayer.
所以我就开始有那样的一个祷告。
And then the Lord began to change my heart.
然后神就开始做工来改变我的心意。
And I went from I am willing to be willing to I am willing.
然后我就从我愿意神来使我成为愿意的，变成了我愿意。
And finally, one day I said yes, Lord.
所以最终有一天，我对主说：“是的，主，我愿意。
”You are worth it.
你是配得的，你值得这样。
And when I did that thing,
当我这样做的时候
，I was a free man.
我就成了一个完全自由的人。
This thing held me.
这件事情捆绑了我。
It was precious to me.
对我来讲是非常宝贵的。
I thought it sort of was me.
我甚至觉得那就是我。
But it was a chain on my neck.
但是呢，实际上是在我脖子上的一个链锁。
He wanted me to find my life in Christ.
神可愿意我能够在基督里面找到我的自由。
I think
找到我的生命。
I think the story in Luke 18 about the rich young ruler.
在路加福音十八章那边有一个年轻富有的官。
You know, the rich young ruler was somebody who was quite confident in himself.
这个年轻富有的官，他自信满满。
He came to him, he's a good master.
他来到他面前说，良善的夫子。
What is it I must do to inherit eternal life?
我必须要做什么才可以承受永生。
The Lord tested him.
主就试验了他。
The Lord said,He reminded him of all the commandments.
他就把所有的诫命都告诉他。
He just spoke to him what the commandments were.
他就把诫命一字一句告诉他。
And that self-deceived man.
那这位自欺的人。
Well, let me back up. The Lord said, why do you call me good?
我现在再退回前面一点，就主问他说，你为什么称我为良善的呢？
He said, no one's good but God.
除了神以外，没有良善。
This young man thought he was good.
其实这个年轻人觉得自己是良善。
Because his answer when the Lord told him to keep this commandment, do not commit adultery, do not steal, do not kill, do not bear false witness.
当神跟他一条一条的诫命告诉他的时候，不能这样子的，不能那样子的时候。
Honor your father and mother.
你要孝顺父母等等。
Do you know what he said to the Lord?
你记得他对主说什么话吗
？He said, "All these I have done since my youth."
他说我从我年幼的时候所有这一切我都遵守了。
Can you imagine telling the Lord that?
你能不能想象一下你可以跟主这样说呢
?Surely he was deceived.
肯定他是一个被蒙蔽的人。
So the Lord in his mercy to deliver us from ourselves sometimes does the unimaginable.
所以神在他的怜悯里头有些时候要为了拯救我们出于自我蒙蔽他会做一件非常难的一件事情。
He said that one man.
他就对这个年轻人说
：“One thing you lack，
你仍然缺少一件。
Remember, he was the rich young ruler.
记得他是一个很富有的人。
He came to him in purple and wonderful attire.
他穿着很华美的衣服。
The Lord says, sell all you have.
主说你要变卖你一切所有的。
Give it to the poor. Follow me.
然后就分给穷人，然后你还要来跟从我。
Young man couldn't do that.
这个年轻人做不到。
He was devastated.
他实在是感觉很沮丧。
Now, first of all, sometimes as Christians, we make this a requirement of being a Christian.
有些时候基督徒我们会要求别人要这样做才能成为基督徒。
The lesson is not that we should all give away all of our money. That's not the lesson the Lord was teaching him.
主在这边所教导的功课并不是说我们要把我们所有的都变卖了分给穷人。
The lesson is you can't do it.
这个功课反而是说你靠自己做不到。
The lesson is only God can do it.
这个功课是只有神能够做到。
And the rich young ruler walked away sad because he had much riches.
然后这个年轻人因为他很富有就忧忧愁愁地走了。
Don't ever impose on the church. The rule is give away all your money. That's how you follow the Lord.
我们不能在教会里边定这样的规矩就是你要跟随主的话你就要变卖一切所有的。
So Peter was alarmed. Do you remember Peter and the apostles? Peter said, "Who then can be saved?"
然后彼得在那边就非常的惊讶，他和其他的使徒，然后彼得就问说，那这样的话，谁还能得救呢？
And the Lord's answer was like Brother Kong.
然后主的回答就好像江弟兄说的那样
，so sweet，
是非常的甜美
，so gentle，
非常的这种慷慨。
He said, "What is impossible with man?"
非常的温柔，他对说人在人是不能的。
It's possible with God.
但是在神凡事都能。
In other words, the Christian life for you and me is impossible.
换句话说，当一个基督徒在你在我其实都是不可能的。
And God will bring us to places in our life where He proves that to us.
神会把我们在我们的生命里面带到一个地步，他会向我们证明这一点。
And He said, "Those of you that follow Me in this life and..." You've given up everything. You will receive manifold in this life and eternal life to come.
你们这一生的时候，放弃一切来跟随我，为着福音放下一切的人，你们会得到百倍，而且要得到永生。
I think that was my experience then.
这是我那个时候的经历。
Another time.
还有一次。
This is when the assembly in Richmond. almost completely fell apart.
这就是当我们在 Richmond 那边的教会几乎完全的就要垮掉
了。It was enormous division.
是一个非常巨大的分裂。
Ripped families apart. It was so terrible.
把很多的家庭都拆开了，这是非常的可怕的一件事。
And I didn't know what to do.
我也不知道该做什么。
I had my business.
我有我自己的事业。
My career was successful.
我自己的职业非常的成功。
My family was blessed.
我的家庭也蒙祝福。
But the one thing that was most precious to me was about to be destroyed.
但是对我来讲，最宝贵的那个东西要马上就要被毁灭了。
I couldn't
被毁坏了。我没有办法承受，对我来讲非常的可怕。
I remember telling the brothers, "No assembly should go through this."
我记得我告诉我的同工们说，没有神的教会应该这样。
I thought, "What do I live for?"
那么这样我还活着干什么呢
？And I remember the Lord put a prayer in my heart.
我记得神把一个祷告放在我的心里。
This is the only thing I could pray for months.
这个就是我那连续几个月唯一的能做的祷告。
I said, Lord,
我说主啊
，Nothing for me.
不要，我不需要任何事情。
Everything for you.
而为着你，你要做一切，要你做一成为一切。
That was a hard prayer to pray.
这是非常难的一个祷告。
But the Lord honored it.
然而神却回答了这个祷告。
And the Lord blessed it.
而且主也祝福。
That's the best answer.
这是最
These brothers could probably give a better answer, Lord. Yes. Does that help?
有帮助。
But we need more men like Brother Kong, like the Lord Jesus, to give those kind of answers that'll lead us from despair into life.
我们需要有更多的像江弟兄这样像主耶稣这样的人，然后他们可以把很多在陷于绝望之中的人带向光明，带向盼望。
Okay, is it time yet?
(笑)大家可以问问题。
I believe that's how the cross works.
我相信这是十字架怎么样的做工。
The cross cuts across who we are.
因为十字架是把我们这个人给他解决掉。
I'll never forget what it said about John the Baptist.
我永远不会忘记关于约翰施洗约翰的这句话。
This has often been a prayer of mine, and I know many saints.
经常我是用这样句话来祷告，很多圣徒也这样祷告。
And John.You know, when he came to him and told him about others, the Lord baptizing and the people being baptized.
人来告诉约施洗约翰说，哦，主耶稣在那边施洗约翰，在那边施洗，很多人都去他那边去。
John made nothing of himself.
但是约翰在那边看自己不是什么。
He said, "I am just the friend of the bridegroom."
我只是新郎的朋友。
Rejoice when I see the bridegroom.
我看见了新郎，我就高兴，我就满足了。
And he said at the end of that the most profound thing.
在那个结尾的时候，他说了这样深刻的一句话。
He said that I may decrease.
他说愿我衰微。
And that he may increase.
然后让他来增加。
I think that's the most important prayer we can pray.
我相信这是我们可以有的一个很最重要的祷告，愿他增加，愿我减少。The third part of the message this morning.
The third part.
Yep.
甘心乐意
willingly live in Jerusalem.
百姓为他们祝福。
Other people bless them.
Yes.
我本以为是神为这些住在神心意中的人祝福。
Originally, I was thinking it's God who is there blessing the people willingly living in Jerusalem.
Yes.
但是是。
But that verse mentions that all the people bless them, bless those people who live in Jerusalem. The 问题是什么？
就是这个百姓为
Why is it that the people, all the people blessed?
Yeah. I'm not sure I have your answer. But just think of it. Here is a people that chose not to.
这边有这么多的人, 他们选择不住在耶路撒冷。
And they saw these people that made a choice, it must have convicted them.
但是当他们看见有些人却拣选住在耶路撒冷的时候, 一定让他们心里面受到责备。
They must have seen how God moved upon these people to willingly choose to live in Jerusalem.
他们一定是看见了神如何在那些人的身上做工, 使他们能够愿意, 甘心乐意地住在耶路撒冷。
And they couldn't help but bless them.
他们就没有办法, 他们只能为他们祝福。
You know, sometimes it's the way the Lord works with conviction to people.
这是有些时候神为什么借着他圣灵在人心之中间做那个责备的工作来帮助人。
It doesn't mean they agree with it or they would do it.
这并不表示说他们也同意, 他们也愿意跟他们一样做。
But they see God worked in those people.
但是他们确实能够看见是神在那些弟兄姊妹的心中做工。
And I think it's great encouragement that the Holy Spirit put that as an end.
所以我相信这是圣灵奇妙的工作, 他在圣经里面把这句话写下来。
God surely blessed them. That goes unspoken.
神一定是祝福了他们, 这个都不用说的。
But even the people blessed them.
甚至连这些其他的百姓都要祝福他们。
They saw how God moved upon them.
因为他们也能够看见神如何在他们的身上运行。
You will never regret.
你也永远不会后悔。
You will never regret.
你不会永远不会后悔。
Making this choice.
因为你这样子拣选，这样子的决定。
You will receive far more than you ever lost.
你要,
the lesson to the rich young ruler and the disciples in this life and that to come.
你永远不会后悔，因为你在今生就要得到百倍，要来世得永生。Are
we done yet?
对，开玩笑。Actually,
follow up on the same passage, I was wondering, like, probably it's like me not knowing the history, so I felt like the people who go back to Jerusalem, they are like, you know, they already gave up everything. So I guess like, why wouldn't they want to live in? Like, they already gave up what they have in, like, you know, Babylon, whatever. But then, so that like, why wouldn't they want to live in Jerusalem? And like, how are the leaders and the people who are cast off, like, especially the leader, like, why would the leader not be the people who are like, you know, willingly? I guess like, why would they choose leader? That's not like that.
I understand. Yeah. Do you want to try to answer?
No, but no, no.
that's the first time I've heard him stutter.
所以苏欣姊妹的问题是个 follow up 的一个问题，他是说到，就是说他们既然已经放弃了巴比伦的那些财富，回到耶路撒冷，他们为什么不愿意住在耶路撒冷？然后第二个就是说到那些做官的那些官长们。 他们是不是也是属于那种不情愿的，然后你是这个意思吗？ 他们是compulsory。为什么官长是不情愿的？为什么对，官长呢，反而是他们不得不住在耶路撒冷，好像也是不属于那种不情愿。 Do the rulers belong to the group that kind of like compulse?
They do. Yeah. The point, we can overthink this, and I think the brother's light was tremendous. As a matter of fact, when I used to read that verse, sister, I used to read that there was only two groups.
Yeah, 他说我们的弟兄,
and I used to read that part about willing had to do with those two groups.
所以以前我也以为只有两个 group, 一个就是有些愿意的，有些不愿意的。
That the leaders were willing.
然后好像这些领袖们也是愿意的。
And the one who drew the lot was willing.
然后那些甚至抽签的人，抽中的人，他们也是愿意。
It wasn't until I discovered what Brother Denton said that I realized there are three groups.
所以当我读到这个弟兄，这位Edward Bennett弟兄，Denton弟兄，他所写的这个时候，我才意识到其实有三种人。
That was light to me.
对我来讲，这是一个光。
For him to say the rulers, you know, they were the civil government. They had to be in Jerusalem. You know, you couldn't catch a plane to Jerusalem and live outside of it.
嗯，他说这些官长们，因为他们是这个政府，官员，他们必须要住在那儿，他们不可能像今天有些人，他们就坐一个火车或者什么的，就晚上回家出城。
In the Old Testament, they took lots very seriously.
在旧约的时代，他们撤迁的这件事情非常的严肃的一件事。
Once you got the lot, you got the lot.
你如果抽中了那个签，你就必须要这样做。
Choice was taken away from the equation.
然后你不可能有自由选择的权利。
This was fate.
这个是你的命运。
You remember in Acts when they drew the lot to replace Judas.
你记不记得在《使徒行传》里边，他们要撤签、抽签来看选中谁来取代犹大
？They were sort of in an Old Testament mentality.
他们那个时候好像就又回到旧约的那个思想思维方式里头。
They never drew a lot after that.
从那个时间以后，他们就再没有用签撤签。
And the fellow that replaced Judas is never mentioned after that.
然后代替犹大的那个使徒，后来呢，他的名字再没有被提起过。
So I think that was real light, brother. And it had.
我相信这是 Daniel 弟兄的所得到的亮光。
God appreciates those two groups, but it's the third group that really is impressive.
神也很欣赏前面两个那个group， 然后但是第三个 group 却是神心里面所喜悦。
Let me try to draw a parallel with an illustration from the Old Testament.
我愿意在旧约里边找一个跟这个平行相关的一个故事。
In Deuteronomy 15.
在
Exodus 21, there are similar stories.
在《使徒行传》二十一章，或者是《生命记》的十五章
，It's about a Hebrew slave that's set free at the end of the 7 years. You have to, in Hebrew, it was pretty just slavery if you wanted. Don't get mad at me. Don't get mad at me. It was pretty just slavery. You could only be in bondage for 7 years, and then you had to set them free.
所以在旧约时代，他们这个犹太人的奴仆。
Exodus 21 might be the best one to show.
Yeah. Okay. Exodus.
Exodus 1.
他们是非常有人性的那种奴隶的制度，因为他们做奴仆、做奴役只要七年时间。
And yet something happens to that slave that was free.
然后对那个已经要得到自由的那个奴隶呢，在他们身上要发生一件事情。
It was like those captives in that came back to the land could live anywhere they wanted to.
你知道那些被掳归回的人，他们回到以色列地以后，他们有自由，他们可以选择住任何地方。
And if you read this story, what you find out is that, well, it's 1 through 6. I'm going by memory. I may be wrong.
Acts 21.
Exodus
21. Oh, yeah. Okay, sorry.
See, I'm slurring my words now. So you better.
Sorry, it's my hearing problem.
No.
出埃及记二十一章。出埃及记。
Anyway, it's a story. I think y'all know the story.
Yeah. 二十一章就是关于奴仆的那个条例。
And so that one who is completely set free does the most remarkable thing.
是那些被完全得到自由、得释放的奴隶，他们做的一件事情是非常令人惊异。
They say, "I will not go free."
他说我不愿意出去自由。
I love my master.
我爱我的主人。
This is a picture of the Christian life.
这个其实是基督徒生活的一个图画。
And he said, "Don't set me free."
他说不要让我自由。
But take me to the door and take an awl. You know what an awl is?
嗯哼，要带我到那个门框那儿。
It's a pointed tool we drive in.
用那个锥子来穿他的耳朵。
And drive the awl through my ear to the door or the doorpost.
然后就带到门前，靠着门框用锥子穿他的耳朵。
This is rough ear piercing.
这个是一个好像打耳孔的一个很不好的一种方式。
And I will be your bond slave or love slave forever.
然后我就要成为你爱的奴仆，服侍主人直到永远。
This is like the people who willingly chose to live in Jerusalem.
这个就是相当于第三个那个群体的，他们就是甘心乐意选择住在耶路撒冷。
They were free to live anywhere they wanted to.
他们其实有自由可以住在任何他们自己选择喜欢的地方。
They could have made their own life.
他们可以来过他们自己的生活。
When the Lord sets us free, we're free indeed.
当主使我们得自由的时候，我们真的就得到自由。
But some take a further step.
但是有一些人，他们就继续往前走一步。
They say, "I will not go free."
我不愿意自由出去。
I want to be your love slave forever.
我愿意永远做你爱的奴仆。
And they offer their ear.
他们就把他们的耳朵献上。
This is what those willingly lived in Jerusalem did.
这就是那些甘心乐意住在耶路撒冷的人他们所做的事。
There was no obligation.
并没有任何的责任。
They weren't forced to do it.
他们并没有被强迫要那样做。
They made the ultimate choice that they would do it.
他们但是却做了这样永远的一个拣选，他们自己要这样做。
And this is how we surrender to the Lord.
这是我们怎么样子来向主完全的降服。
You know, I don't think the emphasis is on, really the emphasis is on the rulers and those that got the lot. Until I saw that third group.
Yeah, 通常读经的人，他们的注意力都放在前面两个群体的人。一直到我看见了这个亮光的时候，注意到了这第三个群体。
I didn't understand this passage.
那个时候我不明白这段话的意义。
I admit I was wrong for years. Brother Dennett was right.
我必须要承认，好多年我的理解是错的。Brother Dennett 是对的。
Does that help somewhat?
Yes.
You don't say yes if it does. I just think the free will offering is the essence of the Christian life.
我觉得这个甘心乐意的祭是我们基督徒生活的那个最美的那个部分，甘心乐意。If I may make this,
yes,
just,
please.
I think the 50,000 captives, they were not originally all from Jerusalem, some from Judea and the surrounding towns. So they are free to return back to their own hometown.
That's right.
Yeah, instead of all go back to Jerusalem. But they all go back for the purpose of rebuild the temple in Jerusalem. But legally, they are not required to live in Jerusalem.
Good answer.
对，刚才就是说到那些回耶路撒冷的被掳归回的人，他们不是说都是从耶路撒冷被掳的，他们都是从周围的一些城，所以他们回归的时候，他们其实是回归去重建圣殿，但是呢，他们还是要回到他们自己原来的家乡，所以在原来的城里头，他不全是在住在耶路撒冷。所以真正愿意住在耶路撒冷的人其实是原来属于耶路撒冷或者愿意回到住在耶路撒冷的人是很少。
I have no idea what you said.
Oh, I just translated for myself.
Oh, you, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, okay.
For those who cannot understand English. 所以弟兄姊妹抓紧时间好吧。
对。
有问题就赶紧问，因为这样我们不用给他拖时间。好像小勇有问题，都没有，哦，没有，没关系。
Thank you guys for asking these questions. These are good questions.
谢谢弟兄姊妹问这些问题，都是非常好的问题。
You remember the story of the Lord Jesus in the temple when he was 12 years old?
你记得主耶稣十二岁的时候上圣殿的这个故事吗？
You remember he was among the teachers of the law, the experts of the law.
你记得他在那个时候就是在那些律法专家那些文士的中间吗？律法师的中间。
He went there for his bar mitzvah and this young Jewish boy.
他那个时候去作为一个犹太人的少年人行他的成年礼。
And he stayed in the temple.
然后他就留在圣殿。
And what is it? His family went a three-day journey, and all of a sudden, the boy Jesus is nowhere to be found.
他的全家人他们回去了，已经走了，过了三天以后才在殿里边找到他。
So they look everywhere. They must have been panicking.
这个对他的父母来讲，其实是一个很大的一个考验，非常的着急。
They go back and find him in the temple with the teachers of the law.
他们过了三天以后遇见他在殿里坐在教师中间。
And it says he was asking questions.
他们这边说到说他在那边问他们问题。
It also says in the verse after that, a verse or so afterwards, and he was answering questions.
也说到他一面听一面问，他也回答他的应，他也应回答他们的问题。
And they were amazed at his answers, this 12-year-old boy.
所以那些听见他的应对的人都非常的吃惊，这个12岁的孩子，12岁的年轻人。
So I always say, it's only the Lord who can ask the right questions.
所以我总是愿意这样说，只有主他知道什么样的问题是好的问题。
And it's only the Lord who can answer the question.
因为这些问题只有主自己能够回答。
I remember many times going to Brother Kong, and he wouldn't give me an answer.
我记得很多次我去问江弟兄问题的时候，他都不回答我。
I didn't think that was exactly fair.
我很多时候觉得这好像不是很公平。
Here I mustered up enough courage to go and expose myself and talk to him and said, "What do you think about this?"
你知道我有时候鼓足了勇气，花了很长的时间鼓足了勇气去问他一些问题，问他说你的看法如何。
And he said, "You seek the Lord about that."
但是他的答案是
That was the answer.
他的答案是你自己去问主。
So I often have to say to people, "I don't know. You seek the Lord about that."
所以很多的时候关于问题，我们的我也回答说你要去询问主。
Surely he has the answer.
肯定主是有答案的。
And his answer will amaze you.
而且他的答案会让你非常的惊奇。
My answer might confuse you.
我的回答也许还让你更加的不清楚。
I think that's the lesson in the temple that day.
我相信这个就是那天发生在圣殿的时候这件事情要教导我们的功课。
因为之前的 message 里面讲到了一点点，就是圣殿所建的那个地址，就是亚伯拉罕献以撒的那个
摩利亚山。
然后第二个就是大卫献祭在阿尔南河场上面，也是那一块地。我想说，我有一点点感觉，但是没有想很清楚。所以希望 Brother Kenny 可以从这个角度来帮我们，帮助我们自己怎么成。
Yeah, okay, got it. You mentioned in your message about Mount Moriah.
Yeah.
It was the place where Abraham offered Isaac and also David purchased that from threshing for Ornan and build the temple.
Yeah.
And she wants to you to share furthermore on this point, how today we, you know, build the temple or building the church on that ground, the Mount Moriah, the threshing floor, and the sacrifice of Isaac.
Yeah.
The Mount Moriah, essentially, it's spiritual. Meaning or principles, how we can apply that to our life.
Yeah, I think that's fair. The Mount Moriah stands for the place of the sacrifice of the only Son, the promised seed. Now, of course, the Lord Jesus was sacrificed on Golgotha. We know that.
Yeah. But 摩利亚山是代表的这个把独生的爱子被杀献祭的那个地方。当然，那个耶稣基督上十字架是在那摩利亚山的另外一个位置，叫做哥哥他。
But on the basis, what Moriah means to us in the building of church, on the basis of the offering of God's promised Son.
所以把摩利亚山作为教会，建造教会的那个原则来看呢，就是第一个点，就是说，神的儿子被杀献祭。
On the basis of all that he did on the cross.
就是他在十字架上所做的一切，所成就的一切。
On the basis of his completed work.
而且是在他已经所成就的那个救恩的一切作为这个根基。
That he stands before God as our intercessor.
而且呢，他现在已经高升，已经在神的右边，作为为我们的代祷的大祭司。
We can build.
在这样的一个根基上头，我们才能够来建立教会。
The building of the house of God is possible.
这样的话，建造神的殿才成为可能。
So I think that's Mount Moriah.
这个是摩利亚山所代表的那个意义。
You know, the temple of God is the place of the Lord's dwelling. We talked about this morning. Place of his habitation.
神的殿是神所居住的所在，是今天早上我们提到了，是神的家，是神居住的地方。
That house is being built for him.
这个是为他所建的那个殿。
And that is what our activity is now on the earth.
这个是我们今天基督徒在地上所做的工。
One young man said to me just a little earlier,
早点时候有一个年轻人来跟我说
that my emphasis seemed to be this weekend more on the corporate life than the individual life.
所以我这个周末的负担好像更重在这个团体的生活而不是在个人的基督徒生活。
I think that's right.
我觉得这是对的。
That was intentional.
这个是我的目的。这是我的这个 意思对。
God cares deeply about every one of us as individual believers.
作为个体的基督徒神对我们每一个人都是非常看重非常爱的。
Everything's made available that we can live a full Christian life.
每一个我们基督徒个人生活所需要的资源主都已经预备丰盛的供应。
But in the end, we're not just to remain individual believers.
但是神的目的不是让我们最终还是做那么一个单独个体的基督徒。
We are the material, God's material for the building of the house of God.
我们是神手中的材料用来建造神的殿神的家。
Remember Peter said, you're living stones.
记得彼得说我们是那个活石。
Being built up a holy temple to the Lord.
我们是这个活石被建造成一个灵宫让神来居住。
We're the actual material.
我们是这个建筑的材料。
So I think you have to bring the individual Christian life into the corporate realm where you'll never understand Jerusalem.
我觉得我们必须要把我们基督徒个人的生活放在这个团体生活的这个背景的里头，这个呀里内容的里头，这样的话我们才能够找到基督徒生活的意义。
So、
最后一个问题
last question. So I guess like how do you know like when you do something for the Lord like you do it like out of your own strength or、
yeah.
out of God and I guess like also like how can you tell like whether others is like doing out of their own strength or like out of God?
That's a good question.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah.
哦、oh, ，他的问题就是说
，How do you know？
对呀、啊，你怎么能够知道你做一件事情来服侍主的时候，你是用你自己的力量做，还是说你是依靠神的力量来做？还有一个问题就是说，你可不可以看见，可以看出来某个人、别人是怎么样子，是靠自己还是靠神 ？Right？ 对。
Yeah, that's a good question. I think you know as you mature in the Lord.
你知道，当你在主里边。属灵上比较成熟的。
As you grow in the Lord, you know, there's only two ways to build.
你知道，只有两种建造的方式。
First Corinthians 3 talks about it.
哥林多前书第三章有说过的。
If any man builds, let him see how he builds.
当人建造的时候，他必须要注意他用什么来建造。
He will build either with gold, silver, or precious stones.
他或者用金银宝石来建造。
Now that's the building work you do. That's God's work.
这个
He's doing it through you.
这种建造呢，其实是神在借着你来建造。
All of those three elements are speak of God. Gold.
Yeah, 所有这三个元素都是讲到神的工作，讲到神跟神有关系，金银宝石。
The character of God, silver, the redemption of God.
金子是说到神的本性，银子是说到神的救赎。
Precious stones.Yes, the work of the Holy Spirit.
You think of it. Yeah, 宝石就是说到圣灵在
我们身上所做的那个雕琢的工作。But then there's another kind of building material in there. It's called wood, hay, and stubble.
然后也提到另外的一些建筑材料，说到是草木和秸和秸。
A lot of times, you know, that's the nature of man. By the way, man is a tree planted by the water, wood.
因为这些草木和秸是代表着人的工作，因为人就像一棵树一样，就像一棵栽在河边的树。
Like, hay is like grass, and it's like us. It's our short life, and it's consumed, it disappears. You know, it talks in James.
草也就像我们人一样，就很快就消失掉了。
And stubble, what do you do with stubble?
禾秸能来做什么呢？就剩下的麦秆。
That's all man's building.
这些是人用来用自己的工所建筑的材料。
Now, where people mess up here, this is not about salvation.
很多人在这边点上有误解，因为这句经节不是讲到我们那个救恩。
Because it says if you build, it will be tested by fire. God will test what you build with.
因为他这边说到，你要这样来建造的时候，个人的工程到有一天，谁要用火来试验它。
And if you build with wood, hay, and stubble, the fire will consume it.
如果你用草木禾秸来建造的话呢，这个火要摧毁它。
It will refine the gold, silver, and precious stone.
但是火呢，却能够炼尽这个金银和宝石。
Now again, this is not about salvation.
再一次的，这边不是说到那个得救的那个救恩。
So this is about building with the right material.
这边是说到我们在建造的时候要用正确的材料来建。
And so the Lord is very patient with us, very kind with us. As a matter of fact, it says, you'll still be saved, but barely saved, if that's all you ever did was build with your own self.
如果你仅仅是用你自己的东西来建造神的工程的话呢，到最后呢，你还是会得救的，但是呢，你却要受亏损，就像经过火一样。
So I think the Lord teaches us, we learn his ways, we learn to not build with what's of ourselves, but as Christ is worked in us, we build with his life.
神在这边所教导我们的功课就是我们要学习如何的来让神先做工在我们的里面，然后让他来建造，而不是用我们自己的力量来建造。
That's the work that will remain.
因为用神的材料建造的话才能够存到永远。
Feel free to give a better answer. That's wonderful. Oh, no. Yeah, he's a slick willy, isn't he?
And brother also mentioned if you have any response or you know after the message you want to share, feel free.
Yeah,
not only just questions, right?
好像说我们现在变成交通聚会了。十二月交通聚会，说哦，我们对这个我们弟兄来，那他的信息我们有什么感觉啊？
So we can treat this as a fellowship.
Brothers and
sisters can feel free to share.
I love that. Everybody hear that?
每个人都听见了吗？就是刚才 Jerry 弟兄说的。
好的，姐妹，你交通。
City of David?
Question about City of David. Yeah, it was mentioned in the message that. Okay, yeah, she still has this question. You mentioned this in the message that after David made king and he captured Jerusalem or set up the fortress of Zion because he knows the will of God.
Yes.
However, he still named the fortress of Zion the city of David instead of the city of God.
Yeah.
Why is that? Even though, you know, he knows and understands God's purpose, God's heart, right?
Yeah.
So you mentioned something in the message,
I did mention something, and I don't get confused. I think it's similar to, like, in the book of Romans. If you look at the book of Romans,
如果你看在罗马书里边,
in chapter 1,
第一章,
it's referred to as God's gospel.
那边有提到说神的福音,
the gospel of God.
神的福音。
But if you look at early in Romans, I don't know if it's Romans 2 or 3, I think it's Romans 3 and Romans 6, Paul calls it my gospel.
好像在后面的那个罗马书的后面呢, 他又提到说是, 保罗也说是这是我的福音。
So I think it's really God and man joined together. It was the city of David. He took it, but it was the city of God at the same time.
我相信这是神和人的这个合一，这个联合。所以这个就好像这边说的，神的福音也是保罗说是我的福音是一样的，就是当大卫把按照着神的旨意把那个城攻取的时候，称它为大卫城，但是它其实也就是神的城。
I think it has to be that way. I think it has to be our city.
我觉得也应该就是这样子的，这个城也应该被称为我们的城。It's
God's city, but it has to be our city too. We have to lay hold of it.
Yeah, 虽然它是神的城，但是同时也是我们的城，因为我们必须要去把它攻取。It's
God and man tabernacle together.
是神在人间，自搭帐幕在人间，是神和人同居。The
only answer I can think of is the gospel when Paul said God's gospel and my gospel twice.
所以当听到你的问题的时候，第一个见到我。
新诗的里面就是说到保罗提到的神的福音和我的福音，这两件事情其实是一件事情。All right, this was a fellowship transition. What happened?
Oh, Jim, go ahead.
Father, you mentioned that there was a division in the church in Richmond back in the days, and so I was just wondering if the father is reconciled, and like, what are some of the lessons from that experience?
所以弟兄有问到，刚才因为弟兄提到在 Richmond 聚会，他们有那次大的分裂。那 Jim 弟兄的问题是，他们你们的弟兄们后来有没有和好？然后你们所学到的功课是什么？Yeah.
This is a hard one to talk about.
这是很难谈的一件事情。You
know, I thought it was a terrible time, as I already said.
我已经提到了，这是一件很，这是一个很可怕、很困难的一段时期。There
was real working to reconcile, and there has been some reconciliation.
有一个真实的努力要去重新和好，而且也有一部分的和好产生。
The position that was taken was so extreme that full reconciliation wasn't possible.
但是因为这个立场是如此的两个走在两个极端，所以完全的那种和好是没有办法做到的。
I mean, we were judged in Richmond as no longer the house of God.
因为有人论断说，我们现在在 Richmond 的聚会已经不再是神的。
We were judged by those that left as the cult that was following me.
那些离开的人，他们就称我们为一个邪教，是一个跟随人的邪教。
I can tell you, I was at the center of the storm.
我可以跟大家讲，我其实就在那个风暴的中心。And
I still have fellowship with some of those brothers that proclaimed that and left.
我仍然跟那些离开的弟兄们，他们这样子称呼我们为邪教的弟兄们，我还跟他们保持一定的交通。
And I don't know, and I won't tread lightly here, but I think, what's it in Corinthians? There must needs be that there is division,
yeah. mm-hmm.
that the approved may be manifested.
Right. 因为在哥林多前书那边，他也是说到，就是像你，我知道你们中间有纷争的事情。他说也是这样的事情，也是必须发生的，好让那些有经验的人被显明出来。
So that, you know, I don't know what the Lord was totally doing. I mean, He was separating, he was dealing. We learned that we weren't to defend ourselves about things and leave it with the Lord. I've told some brothers, they've talked about that this weekend.
我相信神知道他在做什么，很多事情不是我们能够完全明白的。
The conclusion I arrived at, and other brothers who stayed, was we will never be able to reconcile this in the flesh.
那我自己得的结论，以及我们这些留下来的弟兄们，我们的看法是，当我们还在肉身的里头的时候，这种完全的和好呢是不可能。And
the thought we had is we must leave this in a higher court.
我们的想法是我们必须把这件事情有争议的这件事情放在一个更高的法庭里头。
And sometimes you have to do that.
有些时候我们也只能这样做。
Make every attempt, as Paul said, to be at peace with all men.
如果可行的话呢，我们在任何的情况下都是要尽力与众人和睦。
And then leave it.
然而，然而我们就只能把它交给主。
So that's what we did.
这就是我们在那时候所
做的事。And there has been some reconciliation.
而且也有一定的这种一定程度上的和好。
Ones have returned.
也有一些回来的。
I've been at many events with a number of the men that were at the heart of that.
我去过一些我参加过一些聚会，就是有些他们还回来参加。
And we've embraced and, you know, met together.
我们也一同聚集，我们也一同拥抱。
But I don't see us ever gathering again.
但是我也没有、oh. 没有看见有这种可能性，我们能够重新回到一起聚会。
Does that answer your question somewhat without getting too deep? I don't want to.
我想对今天时间差不多了哈，因为刚才鼓励弟兄姐妹有交通，如果问题的话，我们可以都无限量的问题。I encourage brothers and sisters to fellowship, you know, what they learned during this, you know, past few days. I think question wise, maybe we'll just stop here.
Okay.
But instead, you know, I shared something, one thing, okay, my brother shared that touched me very much.That's during the second session, a brother mentioned, when David's longing and God's longing are met, his purpose is fulfilled. I pray that during this, you know, weekend, the Lord open our eyes to see what's important in his heart. And we may be captured by that. And we have a longing to satisfy him, not just ourselves. So when his desire and our desire to satisfy him, glorify him, are met, his purpose is fulfilled.
Yeah. Amen. 弟兄刚才分享的就是在第二篇信息里边 ，Kenny 弟兄的摸到弟兄的一段话，就是说到大卫对圣殿、对圣城的渴慕，和神对这个圣城的那个渴望，当这两件事情结合在一起的时候，神的旨意就可以实现。所以借着这个周末的聚会，我们也希望弟兄姊妹能够看得见神的心意，而且呢，我们自己也求神把那个心意，同样的心意，爱慕他家的这个心意放在我们心中。如果我们能够放下自己的意识，能够跟神的心意相合的话呢，神的旨意在我们中间就能够实现。
I suggest maybe we just stop here today. What we do is okay. We spend some time praying together.
所以我想我的建议就是我们停在这个地方。现在我们的问题解答就停在这里。我们花一些时间祷告。
Some reflection about what we learned.
然后我们可以一同再来复习我们在神面前所领受的。
We ask the Lord to plant the seed deep in our heart.
Yes, 我们求神能够把这个种子更深的扎根在我们的里头，
yeah,
种在我们的里头。
弟兄姐妹有感动就祷告。
有感动的弟兄，yeah. If you have the move of the Spirit, please pray.